My name is Jabbar Shoemate, and I'm the former vice president for the university community and the university's former chief diversity officer. 3 years ago, I was hired by the University of Oklahoma and University of Oklahoma's president, David Boren, to lead the office of university community as its first vice president. The office was created with the express purpose of helping the university community heal from the wounds of unfortunate incidents of racism within the SAE fraternity at OU, and as well was positioned to help the university embrace diversity and inclusivity. Along with many changes being implemented at OU, I was recently informed that the university would be removing the Office of University Community, its staff and students, from its current location at the former SAE Fraternity House, and that the fraternity would eventually be reinstituted. And then on Monday, July 24th, I was called into an office and given two options. And those options were be terminated or resign. It is with great sadness that I must inform my family, my friends, my colleagues, and most important, my students and the public that I was forced to resign my post as vice president for university community. It has been the greatest honor of my life and a privilege to work in that capacity at the University of Oklahoma. I wish to thank you all for the opportunity to be of service. I am making this statement in the spirit of concern, appreciation, and respect for the institution that has given me so much and given so much to this state. I am deeply affected by this, and after close counsel with loved ones and my legal counsel, I've decided to evaluate my legal options in response to these recent events, an option that I could never have imagined taking. I feel forced to make this decision not only as a result of my involuntary resignation, but due to false accusations the university has made, and I anticipate will be making against my character. The nature of these allegations are not only slanderous, but from my perspective constitute a high-tech lynching. I believe that the current administration at the University of Oklahoma is self-inflicting damage and potentially irreparable harm to our state's beloved flagship institution. And I hope that somehow we as Oklahomans can help guide the university back to its path of true excellence and commitment to diversity. As this is a deeply emotional and trying time for me and my family, I would request at this time that all questions be directed to my attorney, Ms. Lindsay Mullinex Ebert.
What you just said that they're making accusations against you. What is the nature of those accusations? What are they accused?
We're not going to go into detail about that at this time, but we fully anticipate that they will be being made public by the university almost instantaneous with Jabbar's statement.
But I mean, you called a press conference that's being streamed live to claim to say that you're evaluating your legal. Are you filing suit for sure?
We're looking into that.
You're looking at it. So you called a press conference to say this, and then you said that you called it a high-tech lynching. but we don't, you're not at liberty to tell us what they've done to constitute that?
We believe that the entire termination and wrongful resignation, forced resignation, is part of that.
Well, right, but like, what are the accusations? I mean, what?
We're going to let them make those public if they choose to. But they have been made to me, personally, when I was talking with the university.
Were you there when Mr. Shoemate was asked to resign?
I was not there.
So were these accusations made during their conversation with him about resigning or terminating, or were those?
Most of the accusations were not made during that conversation.
So when they asked him to resign, was there, did you know why you were being asked to resign, or did they just say leave or get fired?
They made a pretext or brought him a guise of terminating him or asking him to resign over some claims that they made about his use of his state vehicle, which we believe are bogus.
So you'll wait for the university to strike first before and let them say what they want before you all have a chance here in a public forum to discuss?
We've said what we're going to say about the specific character allegations that the university has said. If anyone else has another question, then I'd be willing to take one more question.
I'm sorry, real quick. You said it was they gave you two options, to be terminated or to resign. Did they say that they were eliminating the position at all? Or did they say whether they expect to rehire the position, or was the whole office being terminated?
That was not indicated in the meeting that they had with Mr. Shoemake.
Can you elaborate at all on how it feels that they're going to be reinstating the fraternity into that house again?
Well, of course, part of the reason that this is happening is because Mr. Shoemake made it clear to the university that he didn't think that that was a smart move. So that's all the questions we're going to take.
Can I ask one more? Can you elaborate at all on what kind of legal options you're considering?
We're considering an EEOC claim and a discrimination lawsuit.
Did the university's claims include any potential criminal charges that they were going to make against Mr. Shoemake?
Absolutely not. Thank you for coming.